Hello everyone. We're going to have chapel like this on YouTube today because I know most of you guys are at home. And so I really just want to talk today a little bit about parents and the role that parents play in our lives and how important they are, especially since you're at home, most of you with your parents. So that's going to be our theme for the day. And we're just going to have one song today because I know sometimes it's difficult to be part of a chapel service when we're on YouTube. We're going to do one of those songs that you know really, really well. So if you're at home in your bedroom or you're watching this on TV or if your mom and dad are with you, please would you stand with me and we're going to sing this song together and then have a reading and I'm going to share some thoughts with you guys. Okay, so if we can please stand. Every move I make, I'm making you. You make me move, Jesus. Every breath I take, I breathe in you. Every step I take in you. You are my way, Jesus. Every breath I take, I breathe in you. We'll sing that again. Every move I make, I'm making you. You make me move, Jesus. Every breath I take, I breathe in you. Every step I take in you. You are my way, Jesus. Every breath I take, I breathe in you. Na 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 na. Waves of mercy, waves of grace, everywhere I look I see your face. Your love has captured me. Oh my God, this love, how can it be? Na 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 na. Okay, you can sit down. So I want to read you a reading from Matthew chapter 11, verse 25. And it says this, I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for though you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to children. And so this is a really, really interesting verse, and I think it speaks a lot to it speaks a lot to the way that we relate to God and what God is actually like. And so the best way for us to understand what God is really like is to understand that he sees us as his children. We are his children. And so that's a really, really important thing for us to understand. So what I want to say this morning really is just how much I think we need to be appreciative of everything that our parents do for us. I think it took me a long time as a young person to realize that my parents did so, so, so much for me growing up. And your parents do too. They make a lot of sacrifices for you and they do a lot of stuff for you. And God is no different. And so these are the kinds of things that parents do for us. The first thing that they do for us, which we probably don't even notice that they do for us, is that parents provide for us. And they're always providing for us. They're going out of their way to make sure that we have absolutely everything that we need. They give us food. They give us education. They give us a roof over our heads. They give us clothing. And parents do a lot for us in that way. And we don't even notice it, but it happens every single day. Now, God is the same. The Bible told us in the reading today that God is like our parent, and he provides for us as well. One of the things we understand from reading the Bible is that all things come from God. So even those things that your parents are providing for you, God is giving them the ability to provide them for you. So God is just like our parent too. The second thing that parents do for us all the time is that they protect us. They protect us from stuff we don't even know about. They're protecting us from bad people. They're protecting us from bad situations. They're protecting us from bad influences. Oftentimes, parents are stepping in and protecting us from lots of different stuff. And God is exactly the same way. God is our parent, and he protects us in ways we can't even imagine. Each day, he's protecting us in different ways. The third thing that parents do a lot for us is that they teach us. It's probably crazy to think about this now, but everything that you know about life started out learning that from your parents. Everything you know about the world, your parents taught you. They taught you to sit. They taught you to stand. They taught you to speak. They taught you how to behave. They taught you absolutely everything. And one of the main things that God does is he teaches us how to live in this world. The Bible is full of examples of the best way to do things. And there's lots of great teachings in the Bible about how to live our lives in a right, moral, and good way. Absolutely, God is our parent. And so what I want to say this morning is that the Christian faith is not a complicated thing. It's not difficult for us to understand. Really what it's about is that God is our parent and he loves us and he's doing all these things for us every day. And what he wants from us is to love him back. I want you to imagine that your parents do all these things, great things for you, and you never show them any love. You never say thank you. You just ignore them. They would be really, really hurt if we did that to them. So the same thing is true of God. He's doing so much for us every day. And what he wants for us is to love him back and to show him that we're grateful. And so let's bow our heads and pray. Wherever you are at home, just close your eyes and pray with us. So Lord, I want to thank you firstly for our parents and for everything that they do for us every single day. There's so many ways in which they provide for us, protect us, and teach us. And so we're grateful for them. We're grateful for the hard work that they put into our lives every single day. But we also want to thank you, Lord God, that you are our Father. You are our parent, and you care about us all so deeply, and you want us to love you in return. And so I pray that you would help us to do that, to show our love for you in return, to be grateful for the many things that you give us in our lives. And so, yeah, we just want to pray for the world at the moment and all the things that are happening, that Lord, that you would protect all of us and be with us this week, especially as though some of us are at home. We pray that this would be a good week for each one of us, in Jesus' name, amen. Well, thank you. Thanks for watching and for being a part of our online chapel service today. And look forward to seeing you all next week when things hopefully go back a little bit closer to normal. But have a wonderful, wonderful week. And God bless you all. And if there are parents watching, God bless you guys too. Have a good one. Cheers. Goodbye.